Today we will be focusing on the open, axial and selective coding combined with the mapping schemes, the relationship between the categories, the memos we made during and after the interviews, and a reflection on our research proposal. We will be focusing on a degree of workforce diversity at Ernst & Young. First of all, we will explain and show the three stages of coding which we applied on the taken interviews. It is basically a method of analyzing interview data. The three stages in this are open, axial, and selective coding. We will first start with looking at the open coding procedure. Here we have categorized the answers given by the interviewee to our questions into several themes and small comments. These are located at the right side of the document. It is actually creating categories within the given information, which sort of gives a more clear and brief overview of the content. As not all information contains insight in the applicable categories, this will help to make it more brief and make a more theoretical overview. For example, you can see here that in the answer there has been spoken about how diversity can result in different points of views. This is summarized in the open coding into better and faster solution due to different views. After the open coding part, we can now take a look at the actual coding. Here we will be looking into relationships between the categories from the open coding and how they relate to each other, making new themes again. We have merged and categorized the open coding labels into actual coding. To take the same example of open coding before and look further, the better and faster solutions due to different views have been put into the label positive effects of diversity. And after, we have reorganized them into 6 different labels, as you can see. You can get too much more labels, of course, if you would have a big amount of overviews. But for here, we have been dividing it into 6. Our coding scheme did change after the second interview. In the second interview, a lot of answers contained the topic of sexism, which made a new actual coding category. However, the other actual codes stayed the same due to the same questions which were given. In the last step, selective coding will bring you to the final theory of your coding analyzation. The core concept will be selected, which is related to the actual categories. By this, we can build an explanation or a grounded theory showing the related categories. Here you can see the first graphic scheme we made for creating the selective codes. The rectangles in the picture show the actual coding categories with the related open coding. And in the middle we have the core concept within the scheme. You can see that the relations are made by arrows and whether they are positive or negative by the plus or minus related to the arrow. After some modifications, we came up with a second graphic scheme, which is more organized. In this scheme, the open coding is blue, the actual is green, and the main concept is yellow. The arrows show the relationship between the categories like before. So what are memos? Memos are notes and reflections on data collection, coding and theories. They contain observations on interviewee or interview techniques. For example, did he understand me or was he very nervous with answering the questions? Also, are there any remarks made while coding that there are similar themes that can be grouped together? Theoretical insights like this seems different from the theory had, or are there any unanswered questions? Unfortunately, due to the coronavirus, we could not see any interviewees in person, which made it harder to pick up any non-verbal communication. For example, the first interviewee gave short answers like yes without any explanation. We should try to give a follow-up question, by which the interviewee explains his answer more clearly. With regard to a diversity question, he focused more on ethnicity instead of gender and age. Maybe this was something important for him he wanted to make clear to me. The second interviewee focused a lot on the female rights and positions in the EY firm. This cluster of the same answers could be categorized as a degree of sexism in EY. Are there any argumentation for those relationships? Looking at the graphic scheme of the third coding stages in our research, we can see several relationships. some with a positive reflection to the other, and some negative. For example, we can see that the experience and understanding of a diverse workplace has a positive effect on the view and diversity. This is a relation within the actual coding outcome. However, there are also negative relationships, and of course also from different codes to each other. For example, the negative effect and view on diversity has a negative effect on the selective coding, which is the main concept, the degree of diversity integration. These relationships can of course change from positive to negative whether more interviews will be added in a research. So what new insights did we obtain? We found out that there is a big positive change of diversity at EY. This is mainly due to the globalization of the countries where the EY departments are located. After all information gathered, we are reflecting our research question where we started. We could change the research question into what is the degree of diversity and racism related to sexuality, race, and age at the EY departments. In our theoretical framework, we found out that there is an increase of women in leadership positions and gaining more power in jobs. One of our interviewees told us that every year there are more female partners in the firm and more women in the management committee. Another thing we discussed in the theoretical framework is that a company will depend more on diverse groups because of the different range of ideas, opinions, and experience they have. The interviewees explained to us that a diverse group is important for solution and decision making. So, these examples validate the theoretical framework we have done in our research project. Thank you all for listening to this small video about our research we have done on EY. I hope you enjoyed.